Well, my name is José Manuel Platón, and I come from the Miguel Hernández University in Spain. My colleagues, Gerardo Ruiz and Ruben Chávez, are from the University Michoacana de San Nicolás de Hidalgo in Mexico. We have presented the paper Assessment of Water Availability in the Tancítaro Area to the Fast Willingness to Pay. Okay. In the west central region of Michoacán, Mexico, is located the Tancítaro Peak. Due to economic growth and the development, effective management of environmental services is required, as well as a rational use of them. It is predicted that by the 2030, several large hydrological regions will be found in a critical situation due to a shortage of water. The state of Michoacán stands out for its fruit production, mainly has avocado. Currently in Michoacán, there is a planted area of 169 hectares, from which 64,000 hectares are irrigated and 105,000 hectares are rainfed. The total production is about 548,000 tons per season. The avocado is the source of the development for approximately 39,000 inhabitants distributed in 81 towns and communities. This region is one of the most important areas of the country for its production. A hectare of avocado contains about 156 trees can consume 5.2 times more water than natural forest. The growth of orchards and the economic benefits forces the change from forest to agricultural land and the intensive use of agrochemicals. The exploitation and devastation of the forest has provoked the reduction of the water availability for agricultural uses. Well, here in this river, we have the problem because in the height basin, the inhabitants, the people who live there, the native people, have been using the water for years and years. And nowadays, the destruction of the forest, because they are planting more and more avocado, they are extracting water from the earth. And this is causing problems, not only for the producer of avocado, because in the future, they will have water in a poor quality because of the agrochemicals agrochemicals, but as also a reduction of the water. And it's of course a problem for the inhabitants of the high basin, because in the future they won't have water for life. So it is expected that the water evaluation improves the use efficiency of the water. Our objective is assessing the economic contribution to irrigation in agricultural systems through the payable provision for the obtained benefits. That is, if we put a price for the water, it's possible that the people use less water. And with that money, it's possible that the government improve the quality of the water. And it's possible too that ensures the water for the inhabitants of the high river, high basin in the future. Several methodologies have been used for environmental goods, such as willingness to pay or to accept, contingent valuation, travel cost methodology, or hedonic prices, among others. They are based on the user opinions, as it is not possible to introduce subjectivity. So the aim of this paper is the proposal of an approximation to the price of the water. We're going to create an artificial market where experts will express their opinion about prices. We are going to use fuzzy logic to a better treatment of the information, and we are going to use OWAS too to improve this treatment, because the OWAS allows different degrees of optimism or pessimism. As a result, we are going to determine the equilibrium price. So we're going to estimate two functions, demand, water demand functions and water supply function. For the water demand, we are going to ask experts, the farmers in that area, about the price that they are able to pay. So we are going to propose to them several prices, for example, P1, P2, P3. Every price will be valued with a linguistic level like these ones, with a membership. So if the first, for example, for the first expert, if we provide to them a price P1, if they says any of the of these linguistic levels from 0.2 to 1, we register this this opinion and we follow to the next step, to the next price, for example, P2. He will says his opinion about the second price. If the opinion is totally disagree, so the final price will be P1. But if his opinion is 1 from 2 to 6, we are going to continue to the next one until we found a price with totally disagree. So now we have for each expert, now we have several experts with several opinions. Now we have to aggregate this information. We propose here three methodology to disaggregation. One is the traditional using average means. The second one is assigning different degrees of optimism or pessimism, that is using OWAS. And finally, the third one is according to the confidence degree generated by each expert. We'll start with the first one. The price that experts J will be willing to pay for the water. This price will be the willingness to pay. And the willingness to pay will be the sum of several factors. That is, once we have for each price registered the membership function, for example, for the price 1, we have a membership, for example, 0.4. So we multiply price 1 for 0.4. For the second price, we have registered, obviously, a lower membership function, for example, 0.2. We multiply for the second factor, 0.2, not by the price, but only by the increase in the price. For example, if the first price is 0.1 and the second is 0.2, we registered only the difference, 0.1. As a result, we have a willingness to pay for each expert. And we have to construct the demand function. In the X axis, we put all the prices, P1, P2, P. In the Y axis, we account the numbers of experts that are willing to pay a price equal all over for that P1. That is, for example, 8 experts says that their willingness to pay is higher than P1. So we put here 8 divided by, if the total number of experts is 10, 8 divided by 10, and so on. Here, all the experts have the same importance, the same weight. Second, we are going to use OWAS. This is the definition of the OWA. The OWA is just a way to aggregate information. When we aggregate information using weighting an average mean, we assign a weight to each expert. But here, the weight is not assigned to each expert. The weight is assigned to the opinion of the expert. That is, we have, imagine we have 10 experts and we have 10 opinions. So the first weight is assigned to the first opinion, to the highest opinion. The second is assigned to the second highest opinion. And the last weight is assigned to the lowest opinion, the lowest value. So in this case, to obtain, to aggregate this information, we are going to order the prices obtained from the experts. Then we are going to assign, in this case, we have proposed this, but it's possible to have another proposition, possible to assign 10 to the highest, 9 to the second, and 1 to the lowest. And here, that's the weight of the expert of the opinion J. that is J multiplied divided by the sum of all the opinions. That's as this is an arithmetic progression. So the sum is the first plus the last plus one divided by two. Sorry, the number of opinion multiplied by the number plus one divided by two. And then normalizing them, we have the membership, the weight for each opinion. So in this case, for the demand function, in the abscissal axis, we'll put another, and again, all the prices, and in the y-axis, for example, for P1, we are going to sum all the ways of the opinions of the space who present a willingness to pay higher than P1. For the second price, all the ways of the opinion of the space who present a willingness to pay higher than P2, and so on. With the third methodology is using the confidence degree. This is easier because we only have to assign a creativity to an expert and then convert this creativity into a value from from zero to one, and ensure that all the ways sum one. And the construction of the demand function is similar. As we have three demand functions for the membership of the aggregate function will be obtained as alpha multiplied by the membership for the membership of the first methodology plus beta for the membership of the second methodology plus gamma for the membership function of the third methodology. So with these two normal considerations. The water supply function will be constructed in a similar way, but here we will begin by asking for the higher prices, and we ask about the price that they will be willing to receive for the resource they have. In this case, we ask to inhabitants of the higher basin. In the previous case, we ask to the farmers on the middle and the lower basin. And here, finally, we have the equilibrium price. I'm going to present the results. The results are, well, this is the for example, we have asked 10 experts. This is the confidence degree of each expert. These are the willingness to pay. We have expressed this in pesos. A peso is more or less, 25 pesos is more or less, $20-$25 of euros, more or less, okay? So the willingness to pay of the expert one is 0.5, this is the membership functions, 0.15 multiplied by one. The difference between these two multiplied by one, the difference between these two, 0.15 multiplied by 0.8, and so on. So we will have 10 willingness to pay. And this is the order from the highest to the lowest. Okay. This is the weights for each expert in each of the three methodologies. If we use average means, all the experts have the same weight. If we use probabilities, the experts with highest probability, the fourth, the seventh, and the eighth, will have the highest probabilities, okay? And the space with, for example, number three has a lower confidence, so he will have the lowest probability. And the OWA is obtained, but considering this order, the highest present, the highest weight, and the lowest, the number five present, the lowest weight. And here, that's the membership function. These are the three methodologies, and the thick line, the thick blue line, is the aggregated value. As usual, for lower. Everybody agree not to pay anything, but very few people agree to pay one piso per cubic meter. And this is prices, I have said it before, prices per cubic meter. Then every region has his own way to measure this, the water. But for analytical, for scientific purposes, we use a cubic meters. We have done the same for the water supply function. The average is similar. The MMC is similar. The average all the same. The probability, according to the confidence degree, these spares are different from the spares in the water demand function. And the OWA is according to the order. And here we have the water supply function. To obtain the equilibrium price, because here nobody agrees to receive nothing for the water. But it's clear in that case that everyone agrees to receive one peso at the moment. But we don't know anything about what is going to happen in, for example, in 10 years. But at the moment, everybody agrees to receive one peso. And finally, if we get the equilibrium, there are too many lines, but please focus on the thick lines, the blue line and the red line, that are the aggregated values. So it's possible to get a value of 47 pesos per cubic meter, but it's possible to obtain many other values. Consider only OWAS, or consider only average supply, or average values, or probability values. So for next works, will we discuss this, all the set of results. And finally, these are the conclusions of the paper. Our objective has been to determine the water equilibrium price in the Tancítaro area. Users in the lower middle basin area, the said avocado fringe, have expressed the maximum price they would be willing to pay. Inhabitants of the protected area, high basin, have expressed their opinion about the minimum price required by them to share their water resources. Possilogic has been introduced in the way the experts express their opinions using linguistic labels. The intersection of the demand and supply functions allow obtaining the equilibrium price. We want to point out that this is a preliminary work and we have only used probability, OWAS, and means. But we're working in the application of some OWAS extension like induced OWAS or hesitant fuzzy number like my colleague of the first presentation, or intuitionistic fuzzy numbers. And of course, to increase the number of answers or the number of inquiries to this problem. And that's it. Thank you very much for your attention.